That's what I thought you said. Now let me offer this as a
Hey Hawks, I'm Robert.
And I'm Aiden. Welcome back to Hawk Weekly.
Today, we've got a banger for you.
Aw, quit booming, Boomer. Here's Charlie and Nick with sports.
Welcome back to Hawk Center, Hawks. I'm Charlie.
And I'm Nick.
Pretty slow sports week last week, with only the one football game happening where they ended up losing to Blue Valley High. I don't know, how much was it, Nick? You tell me.
Yeah, unfortunately, Lathe's football lost to Blue Valley 24-7, but we're here to bring you the Hawk Weekly Offensive and Defensive Player of the Year. And so it started off with Defense Player of the Year, Nate Matlack.
And Offense Player of the Year, drumroll please, Prince Relio Fountain. Dominated all year for the Hawks, so congratulations, Nate and Morel. We also had four athletes sign last week to continue their career in college. We had Jackson Blake and Caleb Peterson going to Pitt State for baseball, Jessica Arnold going to Colorado State for soccer, and Nate Matlack going to K-State for football. Congratulations to you four.
All right, Hawks, that's it for sports this week. See you next week.
Hey.
Hey.
Hawks.
Hawks.
What's going on, guys? I'm Evan Hessler, and I'm here with
Nate Matlack.
And today we're going to be talking about the signing that he did. So let's start off with where did you sign and for what?
I signed to Kansas State University for football.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And how did you feel about the signing ceremony? Did it go good?
How did you feel? It was pretty good. I had my family there and everything. It was really fun, actually.
Yeah. And what emotions were going through your head?
It was pretty exciting because, you know, like, I don't know, it's like a big step in my life and got to play college football and stuff, so.
Yeah, yeah. And how long have you been working towards this goal of yours?
Forever. Since, like, second grade, since I've been playing football, and I've played ever since then, so that's pretty much how long it's been.
Yeah. And how would you, do you have any advice for anybody who's wanting to reach that same goal as you?
Pretty much just work hard every day at what you love to do and never stop it doing it. So.
Yeah, and what's your favorite football team?
Professional, probably the Chiefs, but I mean K-State's my favorite other football team, college football team.
Alright. Thank you.
Cool.
Great job, guys, and congrats to Nate and Morel on their Hawk Center accomplishment.
Brief announcement here as we have some Hawks excelling in their craft.
Congrats to these students who are accepting the ECKMEA District Honors Orchestra.
Also, congrats to the 26 Hawks who made it through the tough auditions and made the ECKMEA District Honor Choir.
Wow, that's insane. Anyways, over to Danny and Savannah with some Thanksgiving content.
Hey Hawks, I'm Danny and I'm here with
Austin,
Mark Berman,
Caleb,
Darian,
Azon,
Caitlin.
And we're here to talk about your favorite Thanksgiving foods and traditions. So what's your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Green bean casserole.
Yeah, who makes it?
My mom. Who else?
Do you help?
No.
Wow.
I don't do that. I just watch TV.
I say stuffing.
Stuffing?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have it like on the side or do you actually put it in the turkey?
I put it on the side. I have other stuff around the turkey, so it depends.
I like my grandma's chicken and noodles.
I like my grandma's macaroni.
That's... Me and him got the same grandma, so I like her noodles.
I like green bean casserole.
What's your favorite Thanksgiving tradition?
Going to bed early so that I can do Black Friday shopping the next morning.
Like, do you go like, how, like, are you like actual Black Friday shopping or like Cyber Monday shopping?
No, like Black Friday shopping. Like, I wake up at 5.
Oh my
gosh. Don't waste all my money.
Do you like fight anybody when you get to the stores?
No, I like mind my own business. Like, I do like the little, like, I'll shove you, but I'll keep walking. Like, I'm not gonna verbally attack you.
Not verbally, just physically.
Hanging out with family and getting to see him again, because it's the last time we saw him was like during Christmas last year, so.
Do you guys play any games?
Not really, no.
And what are your guys' favorite traditions? Like playing games, going to somebody else's house?
Chilling with my family.
Yeah, going with my family's house.
Eating. I like eating.
Thanks, guys. That's it for today.
Thanks, ladies. That was some great stuff. Now, here's Matthew with some current events.
Hey, what's up, guys? Today, I just want to give a quick introduction to this newest segment that we're going to have in Hawk Weekly. It's just a current event thing that may or may not return in the future. Basically, what it entails is just talking about whatever's going on outside of East and seeing what people here think of it. Today's topic is going to be Kanye's new album, Jesus King, just talking to people about it. It's kind of a hot topic issue, so we'll see what's going on. All right, and we're here with
Jack Rigdon,
Tristan Channing,
Clay,
Zayden Marduki.
Some of the songs on it are kind of hype, some of them, not so much.
I mean, overall, it's like it's not better than his older albums, but it is like a step of the from his last album.
It's good. There's a lot of Chick-fil-A in it. My favorite part is definitely like at the end of that song, where it's like
Chick-fil-A.
So that's the best part.
Oh, I liked it a lot.
I think it's pretty good. It's definitely not his best album, but it's good, clean, family fun.
Life of Pablo is my favorite. It's probably number two.
It's a mid-tier Kanye album. It's not his best, but it's also not his worst.
Yeah.
What do you think his best is?
Probably Graduation.
Black Skinhead. Just that song individually.
I would say that it's not one of his better albums, but in terms of just the album as a whole, it was a really good album. I liked it a lot.
I would say my favorite album by him is My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. I think that's his best album and one of the best albums of this decade.
Honestly, I'd rather, I like The Old Way better, because I like shouting cuss words in my car listening to Kanye, but I'll just listen to his old albums for that, I guess.
I mean, his ratings will go down. That's all I can say.
How's he gonna make songs about sex now?
That is actually ridiculous.
I don't know exactly how I feel about it. Like, it's Kanye. The man can do what he wants. Like, he can make anything. He can make anything sound good.
I mean, if that's what he wants to do, good for him. It's definitely a different Kanye, but if he can be successful that way, then good for him.
It's hard to tell at this point. Right now, it seems like a publicity stunt, but I guess if he like keeps going and if it actually like kind of like right now, it seems like it like helped him get a bunch of publicity, but I don't know if it's gonna help him get publicity in the long run. So
I really feel like he has a change of heart. I mean, I can't say why.
No,
but I really do feel like he has a change of heart.
Well,
I think that's just like Kanye. Kanye, like, he changes his mood all the time. He's like, I don't know what he
has. I don't think it's publicity thing, because he's been doing this for like a year, and he's not, I don't think he's doing a tour on it either.
Mm-hmm. I believe that he's very mentally unstable, and so I don't think he's gonna stick with that. He said some stuff in the past that he never sticks to anything, so the man will change his sound. He's been doing it his whole career.
I feel like he's known to pull some stunts for publicity, but at the same time, I feel like it's a legitimate change.
And now here's some more Matthew with weather.
What's going on, Hawks? It's your boy Matthew Hanke, and I'm back yet again to bring you guys the weather. I'm sure you guys have had enough on me, even in this segment by now, but you gotta deal with me some more. I'll try to make it quick for you. So what we got this week, as you are aware, on Monday it snowed. It was very exciting, I know, because people like to act like they've never seen snow before, I guess, because that was like all Snapchat was. Everyone was at the windows, like marveling at the snow. Dude, it's snow. It is kind of weird that we're getting it in November, though. It's even weirder that the further along we go in the week, the hotter it gets. You know, it's snowing one day and it's up to like 50 the next. Doesn't make any sense to me. It's a clown world we live in, so what else would you expect? Honestly, aside from that, aside from the wonkiness that has gone onward, really nothing special happening. Look forward to a nicer, warmer weekend. Yeah, that'll be, I'm sure, fun. Have you guys heard of the new, you know what else is wonky and really silly and funny? That really new funny meme. Have you guys heard it? It goes like this. It goes, okay, boomer.
Bro, it's so funny, dude. It's so funny, man. It's really funny when you say it over and 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 over again. Comedy genius right there, dude. And then we, like, it's basically like gentrification of memes. It's a big deal. Almost the biggest deal as how nice it's gonna be this weekend. So that wraps up the weather. I hope you guys enjoyed.
Dang, that's kinda cold. Well, that's all I've got for today, Hawks. Bye now.